Hojik Akoina Leptari Bomopomasi, Nazirakat, Sonapur, Asamni, Arug Institute for Plasma Research, Center of Plasma Physics, Professor Nimai Gauhati University, I Samak Lunara, Formation Service Television Network, Kitakai, the Science, Fortnightly Science News Update Kitamakta, Mapomasi Luxury Bunny, Mapomasi the Haribe Institute, the Center of Plasma Physics, some day, Plasma Research Kissing Institute, City, the Karikari Tori Buga, Matimus in the Karipo Tori Buga, Hibuki Matanda, I call Maruina, Gauhati University Physics Department, you was a Professor Nimai Ga, was a singer, what you would like to have with her moment.
I'm going to Manipur.
A bit history and a present situation and it will play
Especially,
in future.
This earlier name of CPP is CPP IPR is CPP Center of Plasma Physics, and it was. Under Department of Science and Technology, Government of Assam, and it is formed in 1991. So, 1991 to 2009, it is under Department of Science and Technology, Government of India, and it is a granted institute. There is no like provincialized college or school. One-time grant. Then after that, we moved to central government to take over. Then in 2009, May 29, and it was taken over by the government of India and attached to it Institute for Plasma Research, Gandhinagar, Gujarat. So till then, we are under CPP IPR.
How many scientists and the staff and students?
Scientists 12, and student 14.
Pay and everything, it is as per central government.
Yes,
So, as a director, what are your vision, future vision?
We have been working as directed by the our head office. Propose on new projects, that means mainly on applications in fusion plasma and as well as in space plasma. Recently we have submitted one project on Hall thruster. So this is a simulation project, so we are planning to go for an experimental one also.
What are the different area of research going on here? It is confined to plasma only or material science or what are the different aspects?
Mainly, main aim is plasma, basic plasma as well as applications in plasma physics, like in application in fusions and material science.
This is actually simulation lab.
Sir, please speak a little bit about the simulation lab.
We have two clusters. One is used for the simulation,
electronic
simulation. Another is for used for general purpose. So we use this cluster, and this is used for only used for ITER.
ITER India. This is neutronics modeling. So this is actually we can.
Actually.
Everybody can use this cluster. This is for general.
The one that IST they are trying to have now is not fully functioning. Is it of that kind or it is?
Yes.
With server and all that.
It's a parallel basis cluster.
It is very difficult to maintain, isn't it? Only expert can do.
I think. No. It's not. So you can also handle it.
Proper configuration is needed.
You need proper configurations and mainly this online UPS.
Yes. initial installation is a little bit tough, but after that,
this simulation work, how many hours on time you take?
It actually depends on the code. If it is parallelized, then it will take lesser time than the previous code. Normally, if we write a program, we don't think about the memory. But in heavy computation, we should think about the memory. And how can we reduce the memory size that, that the program is using? And then we can distribute the memory in this different processors. And we can use the full capability of processor. Because if we write a program, then we don't think about the capability of the machine. We just think about the program. But in higher computation, we needed that also. Means we have to use the means all the cores of the machines.
So, what is approximate budget about
this part? I think
around 10 lakhs. This is 10 lakhs. Uh-huh. And this is that is
5 or 6.
Around
lakhs.
6 lakhs. Yeah. 6 lakhs. Apart from this, these arrangements, this room arrangement.
I think, how is your progress?
She is working as a project scientist, this project, in Neutronics project. So, we have one commercial software, this is called Attila. This is mainly used for this Neutronics modeling.
Radiation damage.
Radiation damage. So, other software generally, we have this MATLAB, then this
Blasphemous,
then PIC, this Rubik, and we have also this fluid code, MSD code, developed by this Pranjal Bhaiya.
Yes, I know.
This is a small cluster itself, not bigger one.
Sure.
Because they are all tribal people, they don't have any papers.
Projects are going on. One is synthesis of nanomaterials by using thermal plasma. That is, the technique is supersonically expanding the plasma, thus forming different kind of particles. And other project is going, that is the plasma surface interaction experiment. And it will be explained by our my partner, this Asanya Sharma.
She is a very serious research scholar. She completed the coursework. I know her very well. Please explain something.
So, my project will be in a new system. The system is now under fabrications. Okay, this is, you can see, this is just a prototype of our new system. And the project will be to simulate a tokamak diverter regions. In tokamak, there is a region at the bottom of the tokamak, there is a region called diverter. So we want to produce a conditions like diverter in a system, so that we can study the basic plasma physics tokamak diverter related studies in our system. So that system is now under construction.
Yeah.
condenser chamber. This is a vacuum chamber here, and the plasma is actually produced by a torch. This is called a plasma torch. So this is the plasma torch which produces the plasma. That is my process for arc discharge. And you can see this water pipeline. Actually, the plasma produces very hot, around 1 EV temperature. That is.
Advantage is that is here we can have the bulk production of nanoparticles. Okay.
Let me explain. Very recently, in our lab, a constant work has been going on the synthesis of carbon encapsulated magnetic nanoparticles. That is, an iron core will be there and it will be surrounded by different carbon layers. That is, it has a main importance of using in biomedical applications.
Like drugs.
So, for drug delivery.
Please come. You explain this
system,
please.
So, this work was done some time ago in our lab. That is, synthesis of different carbon nanoparticles. And the main importance of our system is that we can have a bulk synthesis of the nanoparticles and condense and form the particles. So no post-treatment of such things are required. So in this system, carbon nanoparticles were synthesized to different control parameters as plasma current, which I have shown there in the plasma system, DC power supply system. And precursors we use acetylene, methane and graphite. One more importance of the system is that in thermal plasma systems, different type of reactants can be used for synthesis.
The new project is to simulate a tokamak diverter results. First, I'll tell you what is tokamak diverter. Actually, you tokamak, that's an international project where people are, in terms of nuclear fusion, people are going to produce energy about means. So the diverter reactions will have an electron density of 10^20 to 10^1 per meter cube. So that's
how. After getting this 80 kilowatt power supply, we achieved up to six.
Right now we are only approaching about 10 megawatt.
That's correct.
So here we are, argon we are using, we are just increasing the currents. Like LP, this is the flow rate of argon.
Main concept is that maintaining the differential pressure across the torch, this part, and the chamber, this part. It is only one single step process. Many people have, in other parts of the world, have also patented.
Our professor,
Ambassador,
is also involved here. All great people are here.
Yes.
Our professor, Mr. Goswami, the project director.
He is also here. Only me, but he is not joining. Almost all the research scholars, they are getting some assistant, isn't it?
Yes, yes.
JRA or something. Yes. Nobody from their pocket. No?
Yes.
Isn't it?
Yes, sir. Okay,
very nice. Very nice. So let me see some other
done under hand pilot. This is Manmohan Singh, and this is Tata P.
Okay. So from pieces by pieces.
Very well maintained, very neat and clean. Come. It's another level.
Yes. Yes, it's fine. I met.
How are you, sir?
Fine, I am fine. So, we are coming to see your laboratory. So, please come again. Please explain something.
I noticed that most of the time, not only any talk of CPB, IPR,
You used to be there.
Now today I am coming with video.
Record everything.
Okay, it's fine. It's fine.
Please explain.
Okay, I'll explain the problem. So, you heard about plasma. Yes. I mean, generally, what in our stitching, most of the plasma are in continuous plasma. Okay, so what they do? They just pump some power, directly power, to gaseous medium to ionize that plasma. So I'll tell he is going to defend his. Nayan Talukdar is going to defend his pre-submission talk. So better he should start something.
Yeah, you please. Man. You please explain what is.
12 volt is an electrode called cathode. So we apply here a high voltage like 225 kilovolt. So when the discharge, when we apply the high voltage, discharge takes place around the insulator sleeve, and initial current sheet is formed across the insulator sleeve. Gradually move upward. So when it reaches the top end of the electrode assembly, the current sheet.
One electrode current is going on. So magnetic field is azimuthal. Magnetic field varies radially. So the point of current sheet that is attached to anode has greater magnetic push than that is attached to the cathode. So one umbrella shape, one parabolic set current sheet will move up.
Yes,
when that reach top, due to radial component of J cross B force, person attached to the anode will collapse at the top of the anode, forming high density, high temperature plasma for very short duration.
So what should be the application for that?
Application, see, kind of source, whatever source, you cannot get X-ray from there, you cannot get ultraviolet ray, it is very difficult. They are mostly UV and visible light from there. Here, you can, if you can put deuterium gas, you will have neutrons, but none of the device in CPP can produce neutrons. None of the device can produce X-ray. None of the device in CPP can produce EUV. So it has lot of applications. So pulse power, why people are trying? You might have heard lectures about laser.
There is more market as well, magnetic cage. So we produce plasma inside that cage. And plasma is basically produced by filament heating, filament etchers technique. So in our case, the filament is act as a cathode, whereas our anode, that means we use one of the magnetic cage. And after production here, the plasma, whole plasma is diffused to the next.
You please speak.
Yes, sir. Then negative hydrogen cells, sir, these are accelerated using a high discharge voltage, high accelerating voltage, and they make it energetic. Generally, in conventional stores, people are using some cesium coated grids and they are putting inside the plasma bulbs. And grids means those are negative hydrogen source based on grids. They have some drawback because to extract this negative hydrogen ion as well as for accelerating, such kind of problems are there. So we have now developed, we are instead of that means cesium coated grids, we are putting some cesium coated constant dust particles. And there are some advantages of this process. And so to coat the cesium, dust, transient dust particles by cesium, we designed this one, this upper portion. This is to coat the transient dust particles, this is cesium coating unit. And dust particles are kept at the top of the chamber, that flange, using some, dust doper, such kind of. And it is vibrating from outside. It is electrically controlled. So dust particles are coming from there, and once cesium oven is fitted on this dusty written that color, it is, and it is evaporated, and it will go to the that column, and when tungsten dust particle will come from the top, and when they will pass to the cesium vapor column, they will coat it with cesium.
Please explain this first. You also want?
Yes, sir.
Yes.
Here, I think.
Wait.
Okay.
Please come.
Yes.
Yes.
Here this is the this is the means we are using cesium oven.
Okay. So after this, where you apply
Yeah, this is means that negative ion concentration density we have measured using Langmuir probe.
Okay.
And as well as optical emission spectroscopy also. And this is the means formula, well-known formula we have used to measure the cesium.
Myself, Daisy Kulita. I am working here in this Astib lab. Last year I have joined here. So just now I started, few days before I have started experiment on dust surging with new magnetic case. With this new magnetic case,
So you are getting your Young Scientist Award, huh?
Young
Scientist Award. So where it was?
This is, I have got in Patna.
Oh yes.
Yes.
Yeah.
This is offered by Plasma Science Society of India.
Okay. Okay.
In 2011.
That means that
this is postdoc award. One senior. He was here, but now he is working at Malaysia.
Here, studies on IAW. What is IAW?
Ion acoustic wave propagation.
Okay, propagation in low pressure hydrogen plasma in the presence of dust. Okay,
so that. You explained that one?
Yes. Yes.
Oscilloscope and concentrator.
So we have
launched.
So we have launched this ion acoustic wave with the help of function generator and oscilloscope by giving, sir.
And function generator is used?
Sir, here inside this there is a mesh type grid, so it is.
This one is the
plasma parameters are then determined, sir.
So this project is how many years running?
This is from 2008.
2008.
Yes, sir.
Sure. Pretty long now.
Yeah, and also now this is the extended part. She is working, and my part was actually up to production of negative ions, and already this is completed. Now she is working on to extract this negative hydrogen ions.
So now you will join where?
I will join Manipur University, but my 50% would be right hand person of Professor Surjala. That project I can't tell other.
This funding agency, since Professor Surjala is not around here, they feel hesitation to give. So if my presence is there, so I will convince the authority.
Sorry. It's part of second.
This is basically a magneton sputtering device, which is used in order to deposit the thin films of various conducting materials. The basic principle is that we use the target as the cathode, and behind the target we set a magnetic field by placing some magnet.
Sir, that is the magnet. That is the magneton setup. The circular disc is there, and that is used as cathode. And the gas used to sputter the material from the target itself. And actually for spectroscopic purpose, we are horizontally keeping it fixed. When we do deposition, we used to put it here. So that vertically, the thin-film deposition takes place. And she is on a leave now, but she is also doing some thin-film preparation using this chemical.
What do my chemical mean?
It is from Gauhati University.
No, it is private. I have been hearing for many years. Now, physically, I want to visit and keep that video with me. In fact, I am leaving Gauhati University also, and I want to show to other people in Manipur.
You are leaving, going to Manipur?
Manipur University.
Oh, it will be very... it is not good news for us.
because of this high energy, no? There is no people in high energy, except this MPB wife, no?
Anyway.
So we missed you. But
anyway.
We need your collaboration.
This is my parents, particularly my father, very old. There is nobody to look after. That is a little bit about family. Otherwise, we have some plan in Manipur also. To do a little bit of. Now, after serving so many years, I have come to the point that if we want to develop in research, really, university's role is very minimal.
We have to have
a very good research institutes like this, IST like this. Mm. I mean, only then we can compete at the international level.
Yes.
In the university, we are doing something, but that is for survival, because we have so many constraints, disturbing constraints. Supposing we cannot leave the university, cannot do like that. So we will see some possibility whether we can do something for a research institute there. So that we have been trying for many years, but I don't know whether to be successful. It requires, in the case of the Assam, we are very fortunate that there was Assam Science Society, there were many people, senior people.
Very neat and clean.
Thank you.
Masiga lunga siga namthadi information service television network ISTV na sandok saba thaka is the science fortnightly science news update matang sta loisili ai koi loisela pasida damuka na nixing jani bwa from this gumba koi center of plasma physics institute for plasma research kisi on atakara ba complexing mai sida sonapur kisi mai sida leiba asigumba ma from asigum na manipur dasu ai koi asigumba institute ma laglagadi hena yam kana bam oigadra hai bisak mane khanjabani lunana asiga namthadi kana sida.